to a new video. Today we're going to be filming finishing series that I'm in the middle of. Now I do have so many series that I'm in the middle of, so there could have been so many books that I picked for this. Sorry about that banging. But I am trying to stick to my April TBR. If you want to see what books are on my April TBR, then go and watch my April TBR video. But I do have like a tentative TBR for this video, so let me just grab those books and then we'll go through that. Now, two are like really long books and two are really short books, so I'm not sure if I'm gonna get them all finished this week, but this is kind of the ones that I'm going for. So this is our tentative TBR for the week. So we have Killer Instinct by Jennifer Lynn Barnes, which is the second book in the Natural series. I started this series last month and loved it. Then we have Swift and Saddled by Lila Sage. So this is going to be part of a series, but the last book is not out yet. But I also read Done and Dusted in March and loved that, so wanted to read the next one. And again, this is like a really short book. Then we have A Court of Mist and Fury, because I also started ACOTAR in March and really liked the first book, but people have said this is their favorite book in the series, so I'm really excited for this one. And then we also have Magnolia Park's Into the Dark. I know it's a big moment. So again, these two books are very chunky, so I don't know if we're going to finish all of them this week, but we'll see where we get to. Now the first one that I'm going to read is Killer Instinct by Jennifer Lynn Barnes, as I keep staring at this on my shelf and I'm like, I want to read you. I also feel like if I get like a book down in the next day or two, I feel like, you know, then we have more hope for reading the bigger books towards the end of the week. So yeah, we're going to start with this one. Again, I have high hopes for this, so we'll see how we get to with it. It kind of gives you more of an insight into like the characters that were in the first one, so very excited for that. But yeah. Literally on my lunch break, so I thought I'd give you a quick update on my book. I got halfway through and I was going to listen to an audiobook today while I was working, but it is not on Spotify or BookBeat or anything. Excuse my dash cam. It's not on Spotify or BookBeat or anything, so that is out of the picture. But yeah, so I'm going to carry on reading it when I get home, and then I was going to start Swift and Saddled on audiobook instead. That's also not on anything, but neither of them are on anything. But I've got halfway through the book, I'm really liking it. I feel like the first book was slightly more fast paced in terms of the case, like the cold case, but this one I feel like is slightly more of an interesting cold case. But yeah, I'm really liking it. I actually have no idea what's going on. I mean, I have like a couple of suspicions on who it might be, but then I'm like, I feel like that might be a little bit too obvious, so I'm not sure if it's going to be that person. But overall, enjoying the book so far. A bit disappointed that I can't listen to it on audio while I'm working, because I would have liked to. But yeah, anyway, enjoying the book. Just wanted to give you a quick update, come on here and let you know what's going on. I'm not feeling it's going to be a 5-star. I'm feeling it might be a 4, probably the same as the Natural, like a 4, 4.5. But we'll see when we get to the end. But yeah, I just thought I'd come and give you that quick update. So I'm going to give you a bit of an update where I am on reading and stuff like that. Earlier I got in the shower, did a nice everything shower, did a hair mask and like exfoliated, put a bit of fake tan on my face so I feel a bit more human. So that's kind of like developing. That's why I still look pale, so bear with. But yeah, I did all of that and then I went and sat downstairs and literally binged the rest of this book. I literally have the like epilogue bit left, so I'm just about to read that, but I kind of know what rating I'm gonna give this. So I'm gonna give this 4 stars. So I think I've rated the Naturals 4 stars, but I'm feeling like that might be slightly better than this one, I feel. Although I didn't guess what was going on in terms of the case in this book, it was slightly underwhelming. Like some aspects of it I was like, oh my good god, oh my gosh, like, how exciting that that's happening. But then other bits I was like, oh, that was a bit underwhelming, you should have just left it, is the other thing. Like, so if you've read this, you might feel the same and know what I'm on about. So that was slightly underwhelming, but I did prefer the gist of the case in this one compared to the one in The Naturals. But I felt that The Naturals was a faster read for me personally, so I feel like I preferred aspects of the first book to this one, but preferred the case in this one, and some of the character storylines as opposed to the case storylines as well. But yeah, that's where we are with that. So I'm giving that 4 stars. So I'm literally about to finish this. I've got like 5 pages. So the next book that I'm going to read for this video is A Court of Mist and Fury. Now this is a hefty book, and I was going to read Swift and Saddled next instead, but I'm not feeling in the mood for Swift and Saddled. I'm feeling in the mood for a fantasy. And obviously this one was on Ad Sensitive TBR for this video, so I am going to read this one instead. Although I am in the mood for a cowboy romance, but I'm leaning, and I know this isn't a cowboy one, but it's in a cowboy series, I am leaning towards Powerless from the Chestnut Spring series. I think it's because Wild Love has just come out and I've just got it today. So I'm kind of like, I want to read that, but I need to read the the rest of the Chestnut Spring series first. So I kind of want to read that one, but yeah, I don't know. I'm feeling in a fantasy mood as well, so I think I'm going to lean towards this one and see how much of this I can get done. I want to read like a good 100-ish pages today if I can. And yeah, I'm going to text my friend in a minute and tell her that I'm starting this book, and she's going to be so excited. And she has just started Magnolia Parks this week, which is one of my favourite series ever, so I'm very excited for her to read that. She's going to be very excited for me to read this, and overall it's going to be very exciting. But yeah, I'm going to start this. I'll come back and give you some thoughts probably tomorrow, and let you know where I got to with it and all that jazz. I thought I'd actually give you an update on where I am with this book. So I've actually just got to part 2, so I'm gonna start that this evening. I've literally just got home from dinner, so I'm gonna start this this evening, the part 2 part. My favorite character is back, he's here, it's so good, I love it, I'm so enjoying this book. Honestly, just read the ACOTAR series, just give it a go. I know, like, it wasn't my thing. I was like, I don't think this is going to be my thing. It is my thing, I love it, and I now have started building my little fantasy section on my bookshelf, because I'm like, right, I think I might be a fantasy girly. It takes me a little bit longer to read because I think, like, I have to really understand what's going on, and there's a lot more, like, descriptive stuff. It's not difficult to understand whatsoever, but there's a lot of like descriptive stuff going into it, you know, like world building, so you can really like picture where the characters are and what they're doing. So I think that aspect takes me a little bit longer to read, but I am still really enjoying it. The romance in this book, oh my god, it's so good. I'm literally like, how many pages in am I? 133, and there's like over 500 pages in this book. I have refused to look at how many pages just in case I get a glimpse at the end of what's going on and I don't want to know. But yeah, I am anxious about what is to come in this book, because if it's this good so far and this is people's favorite, what is going to happen? I'm anxious about it, but I'm very much enjoying it. So yeah, once I have like read a bit more, I don't know if there's like a part 3, I have no idea, because I'm like, like I said, I'm only this far in, and this is part two. So is there going to be like a part three maybe? I'm trying to have a flick through without actually looking at any words. I have no idea, but I'm just, yeah, I'll come back with an update when I'm a little bit further through. Okay, I literally can't see. I can't see any part three. But I'll be back when I've got like a little bit more to say about it. I'm a little bit further through. Probably not when I finish it, because like I feel like I could give an update before then. Like I've got all of this to go. So yeah, I'll be back when I've got an update with it. Through this book, I am obsessed. I'm obsessed. I love it. I love it. I love it. Literally, I don't know how the other books are going to top this, to be quite honest. It's just so good. I'm just having a great time, and I'm like, I must know what's going on. I have a feeling that the end of, because I know that the next book, look, I'm just expressing my thoughts here, so this is not a spoiler because I don't know whether this is true. But I think the next book is going to be the kind of more action-packed, action-led plotline, whereas this one is still like, although it's action-led thing, it's also very character-led too. But I feel like the end of this one's going to end in a way that one can then pick up and be the action-packed book. I don't know if that made any sense, but yeah, something's happening in this book like that they're preparing for, and then I think that it's gonna like end just as that thing's happening, and then the next book is gonna be that thing. I'm trying to explain this without ruining anything, but yeah, I think that's what's gonna happen. Yeah, I'm gonna carry on now and read this book, and I'll let you know maybe when I'm finished or when something dramatic happens. I understand the hype, it's so good. Something just happened and I just feel like I can't love these characters any more than I do. I love them, they're so cute. I just love them. I love it. I have no words. I just love them so much. Like, they're just adorable. If you have read this, you probably just know what bit I've got to, considering like I don't have a lot left. They're just my favourites. I could read so many books on them. Like, this page is like 600 pages. I'm still not finished with them. So I don't know if you can hear me because I'm currently cooking hash browns in the air fryer, but I thought I'd come on here and actually give you an update and actually end this vlog, because I have now finished A Court of Mist and Fury, and I wanted to kind of sit for a couple of days to make sure that this is definitely going to be my rating. But I'm going to give it 5 stars. If I could give it infinity stars, I would. I've literally not stopped thinking about that book. I want it to be a film because there's like one specific scene in there, more of like an action-packed scene, that I just think would make such a good film scene. Like, oh, I just need it in a film. But honestly, the book, so good. I highly recommend you read if you're looking for a fantasy with romance, like a romanticy. Definitely give this one a read. Obviously, you have to read ACOTAR, the first one, first to understand what's going on. But yeah, honestly, so good. Infinity stars, amazing, amazing. I literally can't stop thinking about it. I just want to reread it. But yeah, absolutely obsessed. But those are actually all the books that I'm going to read in this video. I did want to try and read 3 in the week. Obviously, when I did this video, I started it with a tentative TBR and then just didn't get around to that TBR. So I would have liked to have read more than I did. but it has been a week and a half and I just have not got around to reading that much. I literally sat and binged the rest of A Court of Mist and Fury on Saturday. I think I read like 500 pages of that book. Just sat and read all day. But yeah, so good, literally obsessed. And I will definitely be reading A Court of Wings and Ruin very, very soon. And I will also be vlogging that because I feel like I've now got a little Akatar journey that I'm going on. But thank you so much for watching today's video. I'll be back super soon with some more videos. I think I'm going to do like a reading fantasy for a week vlog because I've got like a few fantasy reads to read in May. Which you will actually see in my May TBR video that's coming very soon. So keep your eye out for that. But yeah, thank you so much for watching today's video and I'll see you in another one super, super soon. Bye.